Good morning, guys. I just slept in on accident. So, no first class for me. So, I will go to chemistry later and go back to bed now. Cool beans. Good morning again, guys. It's raining again. It's been raining all day, and it's not supposed to stop. Which kind of worries me because I have to be a bagger tonight, which means I have to go outside and pull in carriages from the parking lot. Which, if you know anything about pulling carriages, it's not fun to do in the rain. So, trying to get my umbrella under these trees. But it's really not fun trying to pull carriages when it's like, oh, pouring the rain outside. So, 50, about 57 degrees today, maybe a little bit lower. It's not cold, it's not warm, so not bad though. Not terrible weather, could be worse. So I'm on my way to chemistry, which I'm not looking forward to the least bit. So you know, I'm just tired of chemistry. You know, I'm burnt out on it, so I think that's why I'm switching my major to something different. I think I'm doing financing and accounting. It's either that or underwater basket weaving. I can't make up my mind. Anyway, so after that, I have a break, and then we'll go to psychology. And since I don't go in until 5, I'm gonna grab some money from the bank and go buy my tires and get them put on. So, finally getting that done. I've been slipping all over the road since last week when it's been raining. So, I'm gonna go to chemistry. I'll see you guys in a few. I swear to you, my chemistry professor is the Energizer Bunny. He will go over the limit. He spent 10 extra minutes on one question today. After class. Half the class got up and left. I didn't this time, actually. Because I thought he had a study guide for us. He was going to give us for the people who stayed. So I was wrong, though. He didn't. So, anywho. That was a boring class, by the way. So, and the reason they call him a professor is because he doesn't teach. He's not a teacher. So. Just that little snippet. So, I'm gonna go to that restaurant out here. The name of it, which has escaped my brain, Zaxby's. I'm gonna go to Zaxby's and get one of those chicken sandwiches I like so much. Those are good. So I'm gonna do that, and then come back here, psychology, then get some money out of the bank. To get my tires, change it to some pants because the temperature's dropping with this rain. It's supposed to rain all evening, and I'm gonna be stuck getting carriages in the rain. So that's gonna be fun, you know, really fun. Great, so I will see you guys in a few. Like Medusa staring at you. I told her, let's go, let's blow the slang to the factory. She told me, get the girl to you. Why did I? As many times as I've sung this song, I can't even do it now. I got camera shot. One thing you ain't considered. I heard you when you told your girl, ooh, we can get it. Admit it, you did it. Let's hop a cab and split it. I'm kidding, we both going to where you living. I got you giggling like a piglet. No, that's the ticket. I hope you're more like Anita Baker than Robin Givens. Now I don't know that lady's let me sit it. I'm just freestyling. Stop freeing, that's it. Apparently it's been a while since I've sung this. Forgive me, I messed up. I normally don't mess up on this song. That really hurt. That hurt big time. Yep. Real bad. Now that's straight cash, homie. Right there. That's where it's at. So I got my money. I'm on my way to Hayworth Tire. Totally recommend Hayworth Tire now. So I'm on my way down there to get my tires put on. I called and they said they had them in. So let's go down here and get them put on and hopefully get better traction and all that good stuff. So, and not have to worry about getting a flat because you have terrible tires. So that'll be least of my worries now. So I got, psychology was all right. Not too bad. So I had a scare earlier. I thought I'd missed my chemistry test when I went to get my oil change the other day. I'm not sure if me and C. Sarah didn't go either. That's one of the reasons I didn't go. So Sarah didn't go, and she if I missed the test, and she missed the test too. So that doesn't make me feel as bad, but I still feel pretty bad about it. But either way, I got a scare out of it. I thought I'd missed the test. And if I missed the test, I failed because I've not done too hot in that class this semester because it's hard and I don't get chemistry anymore. So anyway, so I will see you guys. Well, I may vlog a little bit while I'm here, but I'm not sure yet. Maybe, we'll see. This road's terrible, but let's get my tires. So I'm out of the tire shop now. I got my new tires on. My steering wheel's a little bit off to the left. He told me just to bring it back sometime and they pull it back over a little bit. So it bothers me because I'm OCD. he said it wouldn't hurt anything. I'll just go back sometime later on and get them to throw it back over and do it. But I'll show you. This is driving straight. So that's off to me, and I'm OCD, so it's really bothering me. He said, if it bothers you, then come back and we'll fix it. And I'm like, yeah, it kind of does. Because, like I said, I'm OCD, so it's kind of driving me up a wall right now. But I'll be fine. But I stopped by AutoZone. I have a check engine light, and I stopped by AutoZone. I've got a paper that he gave me. Told me three possible. They do that free check engine light scan thing. Told me I had three options of what could be wrong with it. I'm going with the least one, hopefully, $12 fix. The other one's a $25 fix, and then the other one is just off the wall, which I don't think it is that one, because that would be awful. So, so I will see you guys when I get home. I gotta go home, get ready for work, and then when I get home tonight, I'll try to catch up on these vlogs if my internet's back up. But if it's not back up, there's nothing I can do about it. Blueberry or cinnamon roll? Can't decide. Good morning, Americans. I've called this meeting to inform you that we need to do some serious research to make the Pop-Tart less crumbly. Why? Because I am right now covered in Pop-Tart crumbs. It's an epidemic. It really is. But it can be solved with science. Okay, so anyway. Now that my spotlight's over, I am going on my way to work. I am on my way to work. I'm not going on my way. Am I? That's not even proper English. So, I'm on my way to work. I'm actually on time. I had to change out of my shorts because it's raining and it's cold. The only day I get to go to work in shorts is the day that it gets cold and rains. Sickening. Maybe I'll have a bagger shift next week when it's supposed to be 80 degrees and I'll be like, yes. Then we can wear shorts to work, which I love doing. But I did wear tennis shoes because I'm going to be doing a lot of walking today since I'm a bagger. I have to clean the floors and all that good stuff. So these tires feel really good on this car. They feel really good. It's really quiet. Not near as loud as they were on that other one. Well, the other set of tires. Not quite as loud. Only thing is the steering wheel alignment where I'm OCD, and I'll go back there sometime in the next couple of days or next week sometime and get that fixed. They did a good job. Plus, they filled the tires with nitrogen, so I'm supposed to get better gas mileage. Let's check that out and see if it's true. Oh, yeah, we're going to try that. We are going to test that, that's for sure. So I'm doing 66 miles per hour right now. Let's see if we get better gas mileage. Not too bad. That's including city miles, too. So definitely just a little bit better. Not much, but just a little bit. So now let's go to work. Yay. So Lipton sent me a sample of tea and honey mango pineapple mixed for water. So we're going to try it and see if it's any good. I am home from work. Decent night at work. Didn't have to really deal with the public. So any day you don't have to deal with the public is a better day. I think. So all I did was clean and all that good junk. So it wasn't too bad. I just stopped by Walmart. I didn't vlog in there because I wasn't in there for like 2 minutes. I had to buy fuses for a car, for my car. And replacement fuses, just in case I need them. Because they come with the tool, then I need to get the fuses out. Because I had to pull fuses earlier to get a check engine light to go off. Because there really wasn't anything wrong with it. Just the check engine light decided to go. Bing! So then I was like, oop. So that's how it was. So now I'm going to try to, and I need to get water too. I really needed water. I was out of water for like 2 days. Kept forgetting to stop at Walmart. So finally stopped and got me some water too. So now I'm going to upload a vlog and work on some homework. So I'll see you guys in a few. Okay, this stuff is really good, but tell me that doesn't look like a urine sample. So I'm getting ready to go to bed. Finally got the vlog uploaded, and I'm going to tell you guys a story, something that happened at work today. It's kind of lean back in my Lionel Richie pose for a story. We had this woman come in earlier. I wasn't there for the whole thing, but I saw most of it. She comes in, and she has Mountain Dew and is looking to get cash back on a check, which is normal. But however, she just has a single check and it's already filled out, which we're required to ID people for that because we don't know where it come from. So we ask her for her ID. She gives it to us and it doesn't match. The name on the check does not match the person. So we're like, you don't match the person that's on this. She says, well, it's my mother's. And I said, well, we need your this person's permission to do this check. So, with that said, she gets mad at this. So, we take the check and at first we tell her we can't do it because, frankly, you don't match. She says, but we finally agree if we can get a hold of her, then so be it. So we call this person's cell phone number and the home phone number, and nobody's answered. So she leaves the store mad, comes back in, and then has somebody on the phone to talk to us. And she goes, well, I left my handicapped child in the car to come deal with your expletive here. And at this point, I'm just like kind of laughing in the background. So she says that, and Jeremiah, my manager on duty, talks to her, to the person on the phone, and confirms the address and the phone number and all the stuff on it, and says, well, I guess we'll let you run it because we have to at that point, as long as they have all the information. Which I don't think is right. Which I don't think they should have run it either way. Because if you got more of those stuff. See, we kind of thought the check might have been stolen. So if you think the check might have been stolen, the possibility that there's more and they already have the information, she has called somebody to talk to you on behalf of her trying to break the rules. So I'm not sure, but it's a sticky situation. So, but pretty cool day. She tried to get Matt to vouch for her. She turned around and said, well, I'm in here all the time, and he knows me. He knows me. We don't cash your checks all the time. We have a lot of problem with checks in our store. Anyway, so I'm going to go to bed. It's like 1 o'clock in the morning. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Good night, guys.